Meanwhile, the former commissioner of the Philippine Basketball Association, Noli Iyala, has been tapped to head the Philippine Sports Commission. The appointment was confirmed by Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles. Iyala, who is also executive director of the Samhang Basketball ng Pilipinas and San Miguel Corporation sports director, will replace William Butch Ramirez. In a tweet, the former sports commentator said he is honored by the appointment. Iyala also says he's excited to get to work.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. orders a probe on the release of a fake appointment document that has been circulating online. A fake Malacañang seal and a forged signature and stamp of the chief executive were used on the supposed appointment papers naming former New Era University College of Law Dean Attorney Abraham Espejo Jr. as the new immigration chief. The palace says they have no record of the supposed document. Under the revised penal code, forging the government's seal or the president's signature and stamp are punishable by reclusion temporal or imprisonment from 12 to 20 years.
Wala pong dokumento na ganun sa PMS as a presidential management staff, sa office of the executive secretary, or sa office of the president. Walang record ng dokumento na yon. Yung ganitong klaseng crime can cause instability. And ito po yung pangunahin sa isip ng ating Pangulo na magkakagulo kung ganito yung papabayaan natin mangyari. Hindi rin natin alam kung ano ang maaaring paggamitan ng mga ganong klaseng dokumento. It can cause not just confusion but further crime.
Press Secretary Cruz Angeles urged media outlets that published or aired news items based on the fake appointment papers to coordinate with investigators. But she clarifies this is not meant to intimidate the press.
Hindi kami nananakot ha, ng media. As a matter of fact, ang sinasabi natin may pagkakataon ng media matulungan magbigay ng impormasyon sa ating law enforcement agencies. Ang nagiging liability is kung knowingly ginamit yung dokumento o kasangkot dun sa pag-issue ng dokumento na yon.
The Philippine Supreme Court orders the Metro Manila Development Authority to temporarily stop a disputed program that penalizes traffic violators. This temporary restraining order on the no-contact apprehension policy, or NCAP, also prohibits the Land Transportation Office from giving out motorists' data to all Metro Manila local governments implementing it. The High Court set oral arguments on the NCAP on January 24 of next year. Several transport groups sought the TRO against the local governments of Manila, Quezon City, Valenzuela, Parañaque, and Buntinlupa. The groups claim the NCAP places motorists under constant threat of being arbitrarily apprehended.
Cities in Metro Manila vow to follow the Supreme Court order halting the implementation of the no-contact apprehension policy. But local officials maintain the NCAP was a big help at keeping order on the road. According to the Quezon City government, the policy significantly reduced traffic violations and instilled discipline among motorists. The City of Manila adds fatal incidents also went down since its implementation of the no-contact apprehension a few years back.
Nakita namin almost half yung decrease ng mga violations on traffic sa lungsod ng Maynila. MMDA reports showed na yung decline ng mga traffic violations went down to about, I think, 47%. Even yung mga fatal and non-fatal accidents even went down higher than 50%.
The Metro Manila Development Authority says its traffic enforcers are ready to again patrol the roads following the NCAP suspension.
Naging magandang tool din po itong no-contact apprehension natin, pero dahil nga po may inisyo ng TRO at Supreme Court at niliwanag nga pong kasama po ang MMDA sa sakop nito, ay tutupad po tayo, susunod po tayo. Yung pong physical apprehension po natin, tuloy po yan on the ground through our traffic enforcers.